All right, with the firing of FBI Director James Comey and the possible release of conversation tapes between James Comey and U.S. President Trump, and the possibility or the allegations of Trump spilling, classified information to the Russian foreign minister and the ambassador, I'm wondering, if the president is possibly engaged in a conflict of interest, is this enough to impeach a president?
Well, there's a lot to unpack there, but let's put it this way. Trump's whole presidency, his whole presidential campaign before that was one series of line crossing, you know, norms of behavior that were established for decades. He would break them with impunity. Each time people thought, oh my God, he can't possibly survive that outrageous statement or that ridiculous behavior. And every time he would. And he's been able to successfully lower the bar such that we now judge him by this unbelievably low standard. Things that would have ended anybody else's career, he survives. But there are lines and then there are lines. And I think there's a sense this week that these events, these series of events, really do raise a lot of troubling questions. The firing of the FBI director, the firing of the person at the head of the investigation into the Trump administration, into several of his close associates, we don't know, maybe including Trump himself, but certainly including several of his former campaign director, for example, for their possible alleged collusion with the Russians during the 2016 election campaign. To fire the head of the investigation into your own government is just absolutely clear obstruction of justice. And Trump has made it clear that that was the reason why he fired him. That part of the farce of the last week is their inability to keep a straight story on this. So for the first couple of days, they were trying to pretend, oh, it was the Deputy Attorney General who, on his own initiative, just suddenly decided that Comey had to go because of his mistreatment of Hillary over the emails. Nonsense. So that was a line crossed in itself and raised all kinds of alarm bells and quite justified comparisons to Nixon and Watergate. He follows it up by threatening Comey quite overtly that, oh, I hope there aren't any tapes out there. That is just such aberrant behavior that people start to literally question the president's mental stability. And you can bet your boots there are conversations in the corridors and hallways of Washington on this very subject. I mean, it's been pretty clear until now, but these sorts of things really raise the alarm bells. And then to go into that meeting with the Russians, with their communication staff and all of their equipment in the Oval Office, American media kept out, but their electronic equipment allowed in. And apparently in the course of basically boasting about how much he knew about intelligence, let slip what the Washington Post reports was top-level classified information that had been shared from another government. So there's several concerns here. One is the information itself, which the Russians could use to their advantage, particularly in Syria, it appears. And these are not our friends. These are our adversaries, the Western world's adversaries. And secondly, that if you're going to spill information to an adversary that another government is shared with you, when are they going to share you that information again? So people are just apoplectic about this. And again, it's such unstable behavior. This is the behavior of a person who's just out of control.
Some of the other conversations that have been very topical over the last few days have been, North Korea's very brazen ballistic missile testing. This is the seventh one this year, and in the last few days since this last test, we have not heard from the U.S. president. What should be his approach? Is it diplomacy or is it military action?
The short answer is possibly both. Obviously, military action is the last resort, as anybody would say. It can't be ruled out, particularly with an unstable power like Kim Jong-un and his administration in North Korea, his regime, I should say. The danger here is enormous. Dealing with North Korea with a what many people would call a madman at the head of it would tax the best minds and the best, most sophisticated presidents with the greatest judgment and the greatest understanding of foreign policy. We've got somebody there who has none of those qualities. So it's extremely alarming because you're not dealing on the other side with somebody who reacts in normal, rational ways. This was one of the advantages we had, if I can put it that way, during the Cold War, is at least we knew the Soviets were rational people. They were thugs and bullies and autocrats, but they were at least people you could understand their motivations and how they operated. You can make no such judgments about Kim Jong-un, and frankly, neither can you about Trump. I'm not comparing them in any way, but This is what's so alarming about the situation. I wanted to come back because it didn't answer your first question, which was, are people starting to talk about impeachment? And yes, they are. It's not going to happen tomorrow or anytime soon. But I think there is a growing awareness that this cannot continue, that this is paralyzing the United States. Every day, as we were talking earlier, every day there's some new extraordinary crisis, some new unprecedented event that just is destabilizing all of the institutions of American government. Now, impeachment, however, is a political, not a judicial process. It's quasi, it looks like judicial, but it's basically ultimately comes down to political decision. And when you've got a Republican Congress, they're not going to do it until, I think, not to be overly cynical, until they think Trump is too much of a liability to them. Now, the flip side of that is the Democrats, some Democrats may want to leave him there because he may be an advantage to them. He may help deliver them the Congress in 2018. So it probably won't happen before the midterms, but it may well happen after that.